Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at how you can record animation with iClone Unreal Live Link with Timecode Sync in Unreal for full frame recording. Reallusion software works with Unreal Engine 5 seamlessly and intuitively, and here we will demonstrate how you can use iClone Live Link and Auto Setup to help with your production pipeline. If you're not yet familiar with how to set up Unreal Live Link, please refer to the tutorials in our Reallusion courses page. Okay, let's start off by recording with Live Link. Please ensure that you have both Auto Setup and iClone Live Link installed before you proceed. You can see in this project that we have already transferred over our Kevin character model along with the scene camera, so let's go ahead and activate the link from the source menu in Unreal and Live Link panel in iClone. Make sure to switch the Unreal camera to the active target one for consistency. Once this is done, then we'll have a real-time connection between the programs, as you can see with the camera movement in iClone. This works with all of iClone's motion tools as well, including the face puppet, which I'm testing out here. When I play back, it will combine with the body motion that's already applied, and you'll see it simultaneously appear in both viewports. If you want, you can also transfer motion specifically to Unreal from iClone via motion mode, which is discussed in a different tutorial. In this scenario, we're going to use Live Link Recording. To start, open up the Take Recorder in Unreal and drag the target actor to the source slot from the outliner. You may encounter an FPS error, so remember to change it to the iClone standard setting of 60 frames per second. Once that's set, then you're good to record. Hit the record button in Unreal Take Recorder first, then play back in iClone. Naturally, there will be some unused frames. You'll also notice that there is a lack of memory in this case, which will affect performance, resulting in an apparent frame loss while recording. You'll see a less than ideal result when playing back in Unreal as well. You definitely don't want this in a professional environment, much less when you have a large scene with multiple characters. So let's explore how to resolve this issue. This is where Timecode Sync comes in, which requires two additional plugins to be enabled. If you search Media Framework in the Plugins menu, you'll find Media Framework Utilities and Media I/O Framework, which you need to enable and then restart your UE project. Once enabled, you'll find the new icon on the toolbar. Click on the drop-down icon and select New Empty Media Profile, which will appear in your Content subfolder. There are a couple of important settings here. First, ensure that you enable Override Project Settings. Then select Live Link as the timecode provider. In Subject Key, you'll see a list of linked items. In this case, we're just choosing Kevin. Next, switch Evaluation to Latest and override the frame rate to 60 frames per second. This is an optional setting which depends on the settings in iClone. Go ahead and save. After that, in the Unreal Live Link panel, select your Live Link source and change the evaluation mode to timecode. Then you'll see your character in the viewport sync directly with the present timecode. From there, go to the Take Recorder settings and change the recording clock source to timecode as well. This ensures that the recording process will follow the timecode. In the iClone project settings, you'll want to ensure that time mode is set to by frame, which will enable frame-by-frame playback without affecting PC performance. You can also set the time unit to time to keep a consistent measurement between both programs. Now when we record again in Unreal, the timeline will hold until we begin playback in iClone. This ensures that we can utilize full-frame recording. Although playback speed may appear slow, it will still accurately record every frame. You can notice the time code in both programs is the same. If we check the result, you can see that the recording is perfect with no loss of frames. Next, let's look at how to record crowd animations with Live Link. In this scenario, we have multiple targets, which presents more challenges than the previous example. Again, let's ensure we're in by-frame mode in iClone and the same Take Recorder settings we used in the last example. We can then proceed to record multiple actors in Unreal in a single sequencer. Once we have that take recorded, we can then import it into a new sequencer in Unreal, and you'll see multiple tracks for each of the models, which can be edited and arranged in various ways. Other takes can then be added into that sequencer to simulate a larger crowd of rushing soldiers. This is how you can create a visually stunning cinematic with large groups of detailed characters in no time. Finally, we can do another take with the head soldier guy here. Mr. Smith might be a strange name for a Roman soldier, but it is what it is. We want to again use the same settings as before for this take to remain consistent. The rest of the camera work is up to you in Unreal. That's it for this quick tutorial, guys. We encourage you to experiment with this pipeline as much as you can and take advantage of the benefits to enhance and optimize your workflow. Hopefully you learned a lot, and I'll see you in the next video.